You're listening to the AfterBuzz TV Network, now the largest new media platform on the web, and your number one source for after-show entertainment.
Very good, Johnson.
From the AfterBuzz Studios in Los Angeles, California, presented by Maria Menounos and Bing.com, and streaming live thanks to Akamai Technologies, this is AfterBuzz TV's American Idol After Show. We'll break down tonight's episode and get you all the latest news and gossip. If you'd like to buzz in on tonight's show, you can buzz us at 424-256-1729. That's 424-256-1729. And now, another post-game wrap-up show for your favorite TV show. It's AfterBuzz TV's American Idol After Show.
All right, Idol Nation, what is up? We are bringing the fuel, we are bringing you the fire, we are bringing you what you desire. What is up? We're ready today.
Oh man, did you prepare that?
No, just like right now.
That's good.
Seriously, thanks.
Oh, keep going.
All right, everybody, we know that Bing is for doing, and what are we doing? We're doing another after show for AfterBuzz TV. This is American Idol Season 11, Episode 33. As always, I'm JC, and joined always by my main man, that's right, Mr. Mark Allen. What is up, Mark?
What is the haps on the daps?
Uh-oh.
What's going on?
We're getting some Randy. We are becoming more like Randy.
Yes.
You can't
avoid it. You just embrace it.
Yeah,
we're
making no sense at all, but it sounds cool. And if we just had like a colorful jacket and a pretty flower on our...
You know where you could buy a colorful jacket?
Where?
If you went on Amazon.com.
Oh.
But before you did, if you went to AfterBuzz TV and then clicked on the Amazon banner, and then buy your jacket, then you get, you know, AfterBuzz TV gets a little kickback. It's good for us. It's good for everybody.
Oh, heck yeah. That's perfect. I'm
need
serious.
A new jacket.
Keeps our lights on. Remember, that's the theme. We want to keep our lights on, and we want to keep you guys entertained. As well, just make sure if you're listening to us on iTunes, make sure to comment, subscribe, tell a friend, you know, because that too keeps our lights on, because we do the show for you because we're super fans just like you guys. And everyone in chat roll, make sure you're hitting us up. Remember to call us at 424-256-1729.
Absolutely.
Wow, that was a lot of...
I know.
We can see... Get interactive, folks, because we are.
Yeah, you have to. I mean, we got, you know, people watching, people on the West Coast, on the East Coast, you know. We got Jim Rimmel in Michigan. I made stay up.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
It's global. AfterBuzz is getting global, guys.
That's right.
Well, you know, as always, we always start with a little bit of a recap, so we'll keep it short and sweet, because I think this one's been, we've kind of known this one for a while, so.
Yeah. It's not like we were hoping for it.
No.
Because everybody's great at this point, but it was inevitable.
My girl had to go.
She did.
She was my favorite from, like, way back from the beginning of the show. And
the good thing about this is maybe she can get a head start and work on that album, because I think solo singer-songwriter... with a twist is her genre anyways, you know, that rock and roll, she can,
right,
you know, that's where she's gonna soar. In this competition she fell a little short, but come on, sixth, that's ridiculous.
Yeah, no, she wasn't voted off for having a bad voice.
Exactly.
And we're talking about Elise Testone.
Oh, yes.
For those people just clicking in, Elise had the voice, had it in spades, but she just isn't what, unfortunately, what the demo wants, what America really wants. I mean,
right.
America does want her. I'm sure she's going to have a huge fan base. Her
Absolutely.
Voice is insane. But the people that watch Idol, they don't necessarily go that way.
Mm-mm.
You know, Crystal Bowersox was probably the last person like that, you
right.
know, that had that Janis Joplin thing going on.
You love her.
Who, Crystal Bowersox?
Yeah.
It's just
that's the top reference. If we count, like, if I had $1,000 for every... Wait a second. That's not how the quote goes. I'd have probably like 5,000.
Way to finish strong. Way to finish strong, Mark. No, okay. All right. Well,
but no, I agree with you.
Yeah, okay, let me ask a question here.
Mm-hmm.
Now, she was the oldest contestant this season. She's 28. And do you see maybe next season maybe possibly changing the age range? Because look at everyone else that's left. No one's really, who's the oldest aside
Phillip,
from Elise?
Probably Phillip, right?
And he's maybe, what, early 20s? Probably 22?
Something like that, yeah.
Like when we saw the girls tonight, it was 16, 17, 18.
Yeah, crazy.
Yeah.
And then you got, yeah, then you got 20-year-old Joshua and then however old Phillips is. But so is that's a cutoff. Is 28 the cutoff?
28 is the
right,
cutoff.
So this is the last shot for her. But you think, you're saying they're going to change it, going keep it
maybe
down
they
a little
should,
bit?
Maybe they should lower it. I mean.
I don't think that it's necessary to lower it because, I mean, I mean, you never know.
It's an unfair advantage, don't you think, to like the older contestants? I mean, if it was outside of Elise, who else was there in her age range throughout the season? If you can think, if anyone at anyone at home knows, give us a call. Just hit us up. Let us know who else. Like maybe all I can think of is Adam Brock.
Yeah, I guess so.
And Adam, you know, like in his late 20s.
I don't think it's an unfair advantage. I think it's cool. I think the, one of the reasons that they won't do it is because that last chance or that last, you know, like that those stories that they thrive for at the beginning of the season. You get some of those, you know, twists and turns. But, I mean, I don't know. The young one's bringing it, man.
Yeah, they are. They're bringing the heat. And who we got in the back? I forgot to say hello to a person running the board.
What's happening? I was online. I was trying to find the Jennifer Lopez, Enrique Iglesias tickets, so I wasn't really... Sorry, I was multitasking, but I'm just, you know, I'm just excited because she's going to be on tour, and I went to the last one, so there you go.
Once again, Ronnie and his unrequited love for J-Lo.
As everybody should be. You should always go see her show regardless, no matter what. Just go see it. It's fun, and just do it. And I'll get all my tickets and everything and my clothes for that show through Amazon, but not through regular Amazon, through AfterBuzz TV.
Bingo.
The banner on the top right. I can't sing, but I can sing talk. Okay.
No, wait. We're getting really, we're truly getting self-indulgent here, Ronnie. Did you catch what Mark just did? That was awesome.
About what? What? What?
He went bingo.
We're good. Yeah, we are. We are good.
Tying it all in. I'm telling you.
That's it. The lights are on.
Yeah. Yes. Wow. All of them. The lights are a little brighter now.
That's
yes,
right.
They're kicking in some more money. Thank you, Amazon. No, but now, yeah. So Elise was gone, and you know, now we're down to the top five.
Yep. It's everybody is bringing it tonight.
It is
everybody.
Yes, and let's start off. Let's start right off the bat. We usually go boys, girls, but right now it's we're down to the nitty gritty. You know,
let's jump into it.
Do it.
Yeah.
Start with Holly.
She brought it tonight.
Yeah.
And that's the one thing that for me, and what they were kind of talking about too. I agree with them a lot. This is you know, being the top five, anybody can win it.
Right.
And anybody can peak at the right moment because it's not, they don't get rollover minutes. You know what I'm saying? So it's like not all those votes that they got in the past, it doesn't matter. If they come out and just blow your mind now, like Holly, she brought it tonight. Like her first performance was, you know, went this, you know, the 60s. She did the River Deep, Mountain High.
Right.
And I didn't like it as much as the judges. The judges were just floored. But I don't know, with the big band, and she was kind of working it a little bit, and there was nothing wrong with her vocals, but I just preferred her second song, which I thought was perfect, for the British pop songs, Bleeding Love, Leona Lewis.
Right.
I just thought that was the perfect transition from doing like the, you know, a little bit more of a rock, or well, 60s, like big band, dancing song, and then bring it down, and I was hoping she was going to make it intimate, and she did, just sitting on the piano, and you got to see how much her voice is an instrument. It's just ridiculous how, like, I mean, like they talked about before, there's these singers that can sing everything that are, you know, technically good singers, and then there's singer-songwriters, her being obviously a huge range singer. She just, like, I was just blown away by the second song. I mean, she tripped up maybe once or twice, but with those intimate songs, you get to see those every little thing. But when she went up on those huge notes,
right?
I was blown away.
Which is Holly's specialty, is the big notes. She
right,
is
yeah.
usually the champ of the final note of the night. You know,
she definitely did. Well, she had to run for money with a couple other performers tonight. But what did you think? I mean,
okay, you know, the neat thing about us is that, you know, we do differ in opinion, and I think that's what makes a great show. And obviously, this is not going to be one of those times because I actually agree with you.
Yeah, do you? I mean, which song did you like better for her?
She actually brought it completely. You know, because I've been railing her for weeks, just like thinking, I'm not feeling. I think she should have been taken off maybe 2-3 weeks ago.
Mm-hmm.
I was always calling her being the one being booted off.
Right. Yeah.
I am so glad that she stayed.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Absolutely. She was, I thought she was phenomenal tonight. I was like, who is this?
Yep.
You know, the first song, I agree with you as well. And even in the little things we're agreeing here, that maybe I was swept away in the production of the first song. It was so big.
Yeah, it was.
It seemed very X Factor-ish.
Which were, a lot of them were today. Because, I mean, the 60s, a lot of big band stuff.
Right.
When I was going out with the horns and everything.
Right.
The dancing and the Tina Turner.
Yeah, so. the production was great, and I loved her confidence.
Yeah.
And you could tell that she actually, the last few weeks, it seems like she was just fighting for survival. Now she's fighting because she wants to win it.
Yeah.
And she thinks she can win it. And I think the public is starting to feel the same because America loves an underdog.
Absolutely.
And why not?
We have a couple dark horses in this last five, but yeah, she definitely has a chance now. I mean, a lot of these people, it seemed like since Colton was thrown out a couple weeks ago, now it feels like, okay, if he can go, then anybody can go. So right. It's every week. It's week to week now.
It's like all bets are off, basically. Mm-hmm. And now with Holly, what was that last thing I was going to say? There was one thing I wrote down. I thought she had the best song in round one. I really did. I thought she was the best. And that's weird. You know, it was refreshing.
Right.
Because we've been doing this for so many, you know, we know what Joshua brings. We know Jessica and all the tricks, just the talents that they have in their vocal range. But just to see Holly just like, whoa.
Yeah, finally come through.
Yes.
Because she's always been missing something and it looks like she's finding it.
She is. So that's, I don't think she's going to go home. Every week I always say she's going home. I'm not giving predictions, but I'm just saying I don't think she's going to go home.
All right.
And that's going out on a limb because she's always in the bottom three.
Always.
Always.
Yeah.
For some reason, I think she's going to stay. I really do. But touching on Bleeding Love, the beginning, that first verse, she gave me goosebumps. Mm-hmm. And I was like, wait. Yeah. Oh, Holly's giving me goosebumps.
I was chilled the whole song. The whole song, I was just like, just chilled out.
If you guys are watching, Mark's about to pass out here.
Yeah, but just the whole song and just the whole thing. The whole thing was just, she connected with it, and I thought it was the perfect song for her to do.
It's refreshing because, like you said, you know, people are falling in their slots, you know, for weeks. Like you said about Colton, Colton left, it opened it up. But there's always still your Jessicas, your Phillips. Holly was always like, and there's Holly.
Yeah. She can sing, but she just can't sing. She just can't connect.
You know, it's the growth. And I even wrote down, imagine her 5 years from now, once she gets that life experience.
Mm-hmm. Just performing on the road and stuff like that. So.
Maybe she can be that Celine Dion in that dream of her. She probably wants to perform in Vegas like Celine does at Caesars and have those year-long engagements. And she's on her way. I mean, just keep that fighter spirit that you have. And what's neat about it is, like, we know Skylar's the fighter.
Yeah.
Everyone's like, she's a fighter. Well, Holly, she's like...
Yeah, she hasn't given up yet.
She's the fighter, but she doesn't even tell you about it. You're like, oh, snap.
Yeah, exactly. So, she's not as in your face, a little shy.
Right, And did you notice that the judges actually were backpedaling on their... Because they've been criticizing Holly for weeks.
Right, now. Yeah. And I think everybody thought in the back of their mind, like, okay, she's going to eventually go. Like, it's either her or Elise. Her or Elise, her or Elise. That's what I was thinking for, like, the last 3 weeks. And it wasn't knocking her, saying she was a bad singer. But they even brought that up, too, today. They're like, you know, you deserve to be here. And, you know, and they were backpedaling. Like, oh, no, and don't get me wrong. We thought you should be here the whole time. No, you didn't.
Oh, they were so
no, you didn't. But I mean, she obviously has a great voice, and she's striving at the right point in the whole competition because the top five, nothing matters now. It's just you go out and you try to win it every night.
She's peaking. She's starting to peak, and at the perfect time, 4 weeks left. So, speaking of peaking, let's move on to Skylar, who I think she's been on the crest for a few weeks now. We gave her vocal bouquets, and it was neat. Even on YouTube, some people were actually disagreeing with us. I don't know, with her Jason Aldean song,
right? Yeah.
And that's great. I love to hear that feedback, guys. That's awesome. You know, we beg to differ. Let us differ. No, but for me, Skylar tonight, I'm gonna hear it from America. I did not feel her as much. Yes. I that first song, especially the first song.
Really?
The CCR song,
A Fortunate Son.
Yeah, Clear Water and Revival. That's a tongue twister for me to say. I just, for some reason, I like the beginning. And it's to the point now where if they mess up even on a small part of the song, I'm so focused on it now because it's right now everyone that's left, they're perfect. They're great. They're stars. There's no chance you can't mess up anymore. I'm sorry. I'm becoming Simon here. And the middle, she lost me.
Really?
The run in the middle. And then at the end, and you can bust me on this, she went to her Skylar scream. And it didn't work for me tonight.
Really?
Yes.
Okay.
I don't know. Power up. If we have a power up effect in the back, that'd be awesome. But no. Just, I know, like, Phillips does things to his song. They all have their own signature,
right,
you know, like, move. for some reason, I didn't buy Skylar's for some reason tonight. And I even wrote, I know she's what America wants, but the screaming almost felt a little self-indulgent for me. I
don't know. I couldn't disagree with you more. Because here's what before I was saying, okay, there's going to be the top four, and I think she's going to get third. I was like, I don't think she can win it. She's a country artist. She's going to have the country backing. She's been getting better and better and better and better. This time, in the first song, is the first time that I thought she could win this.
Really?
I thought, just because, like, she has the voice and she has the character that people fall in love with.
Right.
And she was just up there having a blast, because that's what the kind of the 60s were about, with the dancing and the band and whatever. And she was just belting out these, you know, like, just flawless runs and stuff like that, for me at least. And I just felt like she was in her element in the part, like, I think where she lost you, when she kind of was, you know, she went across the stage and was kind of high-fiving everybody down low, and then she was kind of dancing on her way back.
Okay.
I just felt like she was working the crowd, she was singing great, and then she was just in it, just having a blast, like you're at her concert, which I always love.
Right.
And just being this close to the end, I felt like she could finally win this. And that was the first song, which I liked her first song better than her second.
Okay.
But the second song was almost there for me. It was like we're in her music video with like the bench thing that was they were making fun of with the couple on the thing. You don't have to say you love me. But I just felt like she had great vocals there. She kind of made it like a country song too. And the last note in that song was just crazy too for me. I was blown away by her today, because out of all the, you know, Phillip Phillips has his style, but he's not as in your face, or like, I don't feel like he's as memorable as far as his personality goes. And her personality outshines everybody, I think. And then with her vocals and her performance and having fun up there, it's like you want, like, you're drawn into her. Okay. Or I am drawn into her.
No,
you're not at all.
No. No, okay. Now, I was just touching on her first song. The second song?
Mm-hmm.
I actually liked it.
Yeah.
I liked it. I really did. So I'm just saying, I don't know if I'm just being so nitpicky now.
Right, yeah, which is...
You have to. Yeah, I mean, now it's... Because what's going to separate them? Now they're so evenly matched that the slightest little screw-up for me is going to count now.
Right, yeah.
It's a winning time. Mm-hmm. And the second song, I even wrote... I felt I was being a little biased, or I just had some prejudice against her or something, because I was ready to write her off. Mm-hmm. That's what I wrote. But then... That I like the second song better than the first, so we disagree again.
Da-da-da-da.
You know, and the whole,
write that down.
Yes, the whole park thing, but you know, and once again for me, the middle was the weakest part on that song, but the end was spectacular.
Yeah,
you know, so for me, just tonight, her middles were like muddled for me.
I think it came to, for me, saying the second song was better. It was more about song choice, that I just preferred the first song, just the style of it. But I thought they were both just really good. I just feel like she's in her element. She comes out, and just how they were saying, like, it feels like J-Lo was talking about, it feels like they're holding her back, and then, all right, go out there and get them.
Right.
But in the second song, she was more, you know, calm and I don't know, she just works it out for me, and like I think that she can win this now.
Okay, all right. Well, you've been saying,
I didn't think she could win it. I thought she could do very well.
Right.
And with her getting better and better each week, I felt like third place was her fitting spot, and I felt like that was I thought she deserved fourth, but I thought she would get third, just because of how America votes and how I thought, you know, being strategic.
So you think, try
to call it, but I also called that said Colton was going first, so I don't know what I'm talking about.
So you think Fortune Son or Fortune is better than Wind Beneath My Wings a few weeks ago?
No, I don't think that.
So that's interesting. So you think, but that's the song you thought that you think she can win it because of that song.
Yeah, yeah.
Yet you still think Wind Beneath My Wings was better?
I still think, yeah, I think that song was better, just because, just the point in time in the competition, I felt like this with her personality and just her having fun up there, I just feel like she owns it now.
Mm-hmm.
Where before it was like she was fighting to win it, but I never, until this point, I finally feel like she actually could. Before, I mean, I don't know. It was like, wow, that's a great performance, but it wasn't as consistent. But now that she's been growing each week,
you're feeling it.
Yeah, yeah. Maybe it just took a few weeks for me to say, like, oh, okay, maybe she can. Maybe before it was just a little bit too early,
right?
And I wasn't convinced all the way. But
and adding to point for you here for sure is in the middle where I was muddled in the first song.
Mm-hmm.
you did bring up the fact that she was, you know, running to the other side of the stage.
Yeah.
And of course, unless you're Usher or MJ or someone like that, running across the stage and still keeping your vocal tone and pitch perfect,
right, yeah,
it's a hard thing to do. Yeah, it is. So I should give her a pass on it, and I won't.
You can't.
But I won't. No, but now let's move on, I guess, is speaking of pitch and my fave, and I'm bringing up pitch for a reason, Philip Phillips.
Okay. I'm going to let you start just because
you let me start?
Love him too, but I'm going to let you start.
I'm going to start backwards because I'll finish with the letter, but I definitely want to talk about Time of the Season with the Zombies.
Okay.
I didn't like the song.
You didn't like it?
No, absolutely not.
Why not?
I hated it. And I've never hated anything of Phillips.
I hated it too. It was,
oh, really?
Yeah, I just that falsetto, and it felt like he didn't even like it.
Was he on pitch? When he was going high?
Well,
like
you
he
saw
was
at the
struggling.
very beginning, he took out his ear piece.
I missed that.
Yeah, which he had it in for the first like couple seconds, and then he realized he couldn't, he didn't want to keep it in. So maybe that was part of it. But, I mean, maybe we had to be there because they kind of liked it, whatever. I mean, I liked the song, but not for him. I didn't like the song. And they're saying, oh, you can sing the melody. But I kind of wish he wouldn't have. I don't know. He just lost me, and it just felt like it wasn't a song for him, and he wasn't enjoying it. And after it, he kind of felt like, and you know, he might have had a bad performance,
right?
You know, it might have been the ear thing, and it kind of threw him off. And then he just, you know, couldn't connect with the chorus, which happens. But he dropped it for me.
Absolutely, absolutely. I think if he's ever going to be in trouble, because, you know, if you look at, you know, Vote for the Worst, the white guy with guitar, you know, they're going for season 5 and making Philip Phillips the winner and things like that. If he's in trouble any week, it's going to be this week.
I agree with you.
Absolutely. Yeah. This song, it was, for me, I think he struggled to hit the high notes, and it was a tail.
Which is hard to hit anyways. I mean, yeah, it's not an easy song, but.
He was contorting into it. He's doing his Philip Phillips face, like, and just. Maybe if you just focused on the face and didn't listen to the vocals, I'm sure half of America's 14-year-old girls are like, oh, he's so cute.
Yeah.
And then they were swooning with that. But if you listen to it, it was a train wreck. I even wrote train wreck, and I hate Sin is my boy.
I know if he would have changed it up and not sang the melody, I think they would have gave him, they would have been like, oh yeah, well, we already know you can do that. Let's see you do something else. Well, it's with that song, it was a lose-lose for me.
Maybe it was the spirit of Elise. Ooh, because in the background, it was tie-dye. And I was like, oh no, that's like, kinda, that's Elise juju. Oh no, man, it's going to mess him up.
It just didn't match up. And I kind of like, when he was singing, like, and then he had the three background singers on to his right, it just seemed like they were kind of like worried about him too. Like, what can we do to help him?
And what were the judges thinking? Seriously, I thought it was horrible critique because they loved it. I mean, like you said, were they listening to something else? But no, I don't understand how that song could have been good. I'm sorry.
Yeah. It wasn't a song like, if it is a slow song and you're going to go up with a falsetto, make it a love song or make it something that's going to, you know.
Right.
It's the time of the season. Why? Because the seasons are changing now? Like, oh my God, you're right. No, I do kind of feel my throat hurts because it's hot from cold, hot to cold. But no, like, no. It just...
You know,
I don't know. The only best part of the song is "What's Your Name? Who's Your Daddy?" That's the part that everybody loves. And I was like, oh yeah, that's a cool part.
A great man once told me to stay in your lane.
Mm-hmm.
And he says that. You know who that man is?
Yeah.
It's you.
Oh, yeah. I said that?
You've said that all season, and I'm starting to believe it now. As we're getting to the finals, they all need to start. It's the time of experimentation is over.
Yeah.
It's done. And they need to stay in their lane. And that's why the letter, his first song, for me, was more Philip Phillips-esque.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Yeah, it was.
He stayed in his lane.
And he rocked it. I mean, it did sound very Dave Matthews-y, which it usually does. And, I mean, I guess it's been a tough couple weeks for me for his choices of songs. Because, like, last week when he did the Dave Matthews Band song, I was like, maybe he should have did that, like, way before. Or did, like, if you're going to do a D&B song now, like, do Crash or something that, you know, not a song that not everybody knows. But if you're going to do that, establish that early or something.
Right.
So now if he's doing this kind of stuff, and I just don't agree with it. But for his first song tonight, I felt like it was him. He was in the zone. He was having fun. And it really worked for me.
You notice, actually, I looked over to you and we were both bobbing our heads.
Because sometimes he does a song like that and it's like the production is too crazy and it's too big. But with this one, it felt like it was a perfect balance.
Yeah, no, he had a great run. He Phillip Phillips it and stayed in his lane, all the key phrases. But you know what? He just rocked. He rocked. He jammed. I loved it. Round one, I loved him. He and Holly were my favorites out of round one. But that second song, okay, what do you think? We're going by, what should we judge more? How good his first song was or just how bad that second song was? Ronnie, what do you think?
Just kidding.
I always go with the positive.
Okay, there we go.
Because everybody has a bad song or bad. You know, it's not easy, as we know. Because if you made it this far, a lot of things went your way. You obviously are very talented. So I'm gonna, give him a pass. But is America gonna give him a pass? Like, are all those websites that are pushing for him gonna help him more? I mean, I think he's gonna need it. But
don't worry. We're gonna check something at the end of the show. We're gonna find out just how good he's doing.
Yes, we have to check that.
Yes, and it's gonna be up to the second. So we're getting rid of the Zabba search, but we've got something that tends to predict who's gonna go home and who's gonna stay. So stay tuned for that. But now let's move into someone who did get sent home, but was saved.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus.
You're welcome.
Jessica Sanchez. Are you alluding that you are Jesus?
I didn't say anything. AFTERBUZZ.
Is that like an exclusive or something?
It was just a message from Jesus also.
Oh, there we go.
Ronnie's like, I am paying attention. Jerk.
But no. All right, let's move on to BB Chaz.
Yes.
And Proud Mary What should we start with? Joe Cocker, you are beautiful to me. What is it? You are so beautiful to me.
Oh, thank you.
You are.
You're beautiful.
He's got really nice teeth, folks. He should have his own Twitter page for his teeth.
I gotta put me on the spot like that. I have one for my teeth.
Do you really?
No, that'd be weird. For my dog.
Though. Actually, okay, sorry. Self-indulgent episode here. Someone told me to start a Twitter page for my teeth.
Oh, that's kind of cool. that's the nicest thing anybody's ever sent to me before.
It's kind of weird.
Yeah.
But okay. Let's bring it back.
What would you call that, though? Because you already have a creative one for yourself.
I know. We'll let you guys tweet about it. Hit us up. No, God, sorry. We're here for Idol.
Please.
Okay. Proud Mary, what'd you think of Tina Turner's classic done by BB Chaz?
I thought, taking on a big monster like Tina Turner is crazy anyways. And they even talked about that, her being 16 and taking on this huge thing. I thought it was awesome. I thought she looked great. She looked very mature. She was very professional. It was the first time dancing and really, trying the choreography or whatever she was doing on stage. I felt like the dancing, the singing, the stage work, the voice, I felt like she was an entertainer throughout. I loved it. I loved the look. I don't know. I thought Randy was crazy for saying for everything that he was saying, how he didn't think that, he didn't really connect, whatever. Yeah. I'm like, man, you're just too old. You're too into Tina Turner. So coming from a younger perspective, I thought she killed it.
Then call me the Crypt Keeper because I'm about to bring the heat here.
Bring it.
I did not like the song
choice.
You
didn't like it?
It's nothing against her. I just didn't like the song choice for her. I just didn't. Once again, staying in your lane. Right now, we're getting towards the end.
Well, you want ballad after ballad?
By now, if they're not gone now, people aren't going to get tired of them by now. I mean, seriously, we've listened to him now for how many weeks now? I think it's not going to put her in trouble, but I just don't think it was the right song for her. I do agree with Randy, actually. So, yeah. I'm the Yoda here, yo. That's right. Oh, God, I just said yo like Randy.
Yeah. Well, you agree with him and you talk like him. Yeah. I don't know. I just felt like, did you think the dancing just didn't connect or what? Or did you think because it was too busy?
Here's the thing. The dancing, I rarely look at that. Because I learned a few weeks ago, whenever they give them dancing numbers, it just looks like a beautiful disaster.
Well, usually, especially when they have the three girls, which they did kind of slip up, whatever, when they did their trio. But I don't know, just taking on those dance moves and singing, because she already can sing flawless and without even thinking about it. She just goes out there, I'll just nail the song and just, she does it. But with this one, she she pulled off the dance moves for me. I don't know. I just felt like she was entertaining and just had fun up there. I thought it was really, really good.
Okay. This is awesome because we're very passionate, and I think we both backed it up because I just didn't like the song choice.
I'm not talking to you after
this. All right, dude. Our bromance is done. It's done. It's over, man. I can't even look at you anymore, man. That's why you have to listen to us on iTunes instead.
we're wearing masks.
we focused on one song. Let's move on to the Joe Cocker. Is it Crocker or Cocker? It's Cocker. Joe Cocker song.
Yeah.
You Are So Beautiful to Me. And kudos. Ronnie can cue an applause for Jimmy. Jimmy gave the perfect instruction. He got rid of the piano for this for the song.
And he brought in the 12 string, which I didn't see the 12 string. It was a 6 string guitar that the guy was playing.
There you go. See,
what's up with that?
So
was there a 12 string in the back or something?
I was just so focused on the fact that there was no piano.
Which, yeah, so it, you know, made it different. So
no, because it would have made it. It would have, like, they didn't want it to be loungy. They didn't want, you know, and since we do talk about her always doing ballads, and if that rubs people the wrong way, or if people will get tired of it. For me, that song, it was as, and I hated that J-Lo said it because I wanted to say it on the show. Mm-hmm. It reminded me of I Will Always Love You. Mm-hmm. Because it was so, it was perfect.
I almost thought you said I hate J-Lo, and I was just going to have to say, wait a minute now. Wait a minute, sir.
We're not about great hating. Things. We're not, and actually, she, you know, I will say this. It's an AfterBuzz exclusive. J-Lo is good looking.
Ooh.
Yeah, I didn't
really
know.
Really think so?
Yeah, I just noticed that.
That
tonight.
Ain't an exclusive. It's the truth. No. It's, yeah. It's the truth.
After Buzz extrudes.
I just wanted to get under Ronnie's skin, man. So he can, like,
I'm good.
He can, like, she, mute me or something.
She did look gorgeous. Again.
Yes, but.
Man.
He just muted me. He just muted me. He freaking just muted me, man. I love you, Ronnie. That's awesome. But that was one of my favorite songs of this season. Just for some reason. The little
did you
things.
Get goosebumps?
I got, yes. I let's see. I always write if I got goosebumps. No, I didn't write goosebumps.
See, that's the thing for me. Like, I felt like the performance was flawless. Like, she sang it beautifully. And, you know, with, like, the cool falsetto stuff that she was doing. And I don't know. Like, for this, I hate it because before we talked about what was her name? That was on
Paul
the show.
Abdul.
That was on the show last week.
At least this time.
No, on our show.
Elizabeth de Razo.
Oh, yeah, Elizabeth de Razo. Yeah, she was talking about that she doesn't connect, whatever. But I don't know. I thought the song was beautiful, pure and everything. I wanted to be, like, wrapped up in emotion with it. Uh-huh. And I wasn't, but Randy said it perfectly when he said she is a pro, just how she can sing and just effortless. And I don't know. I thought it was very beautiful. So you liked the song? I mean, I thought it was cool.
Don't help me out, man. No, you gave me that look like I'm helping you out, JC. Thank
you. I know. I'm saying, like, I was mad. I was like, no, she was right last week.
But, okay, I will agree with you guys that before she went on the song, when they did the trio, they asked all three girls, like, Ryan was asking them just, like, you know, to impersonate each other. And Skylar and Holly, they were cutting loose. They were talking about bananas and all this. And then when he talked to Jessica, Jessica was like, yes, Ryan.
Yeah.
She was on. Uh-huh. And that did rub me a little bit wrong. And it was maybe because just listening to what you guys had to say. And you're right. She just, like, kind of turned it on. Mm-hmm. But I can't take anything away from her from this performance.
I agree, yeah.
It was even the sweetness, the delicateness, and what they said. And I wanted to talk to you about that. Talk to me about vibrato at the end, how she holds those notes, those straight notes.
Yeah.
And then at the end, she can still, flutter.
Still give it. Yeah.
Is that hard to do?
Thing that I need to work on is vibrato, just because, I mean, with her, it is definitely something you can work on and make better. Mm-hmm. But a lot of people, like, I think her and Joshua and stuff, like, they just have that. Anyways, and it is easier to do it on falsetto notes, and the higher notes is easier to get vibrato, or on the really low notes, it's easier to. But in the middle range, but
can you do a vibrato in the middle range?
Anybody. Yeah, you can.
Really?
I'm going to Christina Sayers, that was on a couple weeks ago. She can just vibrato the
really?
World. But the only thing is, like, some people that can do vibrato very well, they'll overuse it.
Yeah.
And, like, try to, when they're not on pitch correctly, they'll use a lot of vibrato to make it seem like they are. They'll kind of hide that they're off pitch.
That's some knowledge right there. Yeah. No,
but
for sure.
You know what's one thing that I was thinking about? If Jessica embraced the younger fan base, I think that she could she would absolutely win this competition. Like, I know with her, you know, her personality and stuff, like, she's cute and fun, whatever. Huh. But when she was with the trio, it kind of seemed like she was on. But I think if from day one or from day now, if she came out like, you know, I just want to do this for like the younger girls, like representing the younger girls, if she made the younger girl vote feel like they were part of her project about pushing her and like, oh, that's, you know, Jessica is like standing up for us, like that's our person, you know. If she was like, you know, tonight, you know, I just want to represent for the younger girls, you know, being the youngest girl in the competition,
what could she sing? Do you think, is there a song? Like,
I'm saying say that.
Okay,
I think that would help her out so much, and I think that's why she was in danger before. And, you know, like the young girls voting for the dudes, like even on like The Voice, when there was four different times where, and all in the same week, there's four different votes, and the audience had to vote and save one person from each team, right? And there's two girls and one guy in each one. Each time the guy was saved. So I think the younger girl vote, which it's like the 14 to 24 year old girls are the ones that buy the albums. They're also the ones that are going to be voting. That's the fan base. That's what you have to tackle. You have to make them feel like they're a part of you. So I think if Jessica would say that, or just, you know, like, which I think she embraces that she's a young girl on the show, and she just doesn't talk about that kind of stuff. I think that would really help her.
I think she has tried that this week. I noticed her try, but it still came off robotic. I think there was like,
well, but I'm saying like actually say that. Like,
okay.
I'm, you know, I just want to represent for the young girls out there. You know, just like that girl power. I think she needs that, because otherwise, I don't think she can win this. Just because the personality factor. Skylar just outshines her.
Right.
And now that Holly's singing almost as good, right, if not better, you know what I mean? So,
well, do you want to move, because we're talking about the girls so much, do you want to move on, like skip real quick and go to like the trio and the duet?
Let's talk about those. Yeah.
Yeah, because I always ask you to start. Let me talk about the trio real quick.
Yes. Do it, please.
Thank you. No, it's... I like the trio better than the duet. I will say, I thought the duet was a train wreck.
I wouldn't say train wreck. I thought it was awkward, but it was funny. Weird. Like, it was more like a joke, it seemed like.
Yeah, it was charming, I guess you could say. Yeah. That's the nicest word I could think about it.
If they were just out there like a boy band working the crowd, then that might have been better.
Yeah, because they weren't looking at each other, and like, you know.
Well, then if they worked, I mean, I understand that they didn't want to be like make eye contact while they're singing those words, but.
Could it be now? Could that be the detracting point of youth? Because, as you know, guys just get more comfortable, and like girls get more comfortable in their skin, and they're 20 and 22. So, you know, hey, I'm not gonna look at him. No, I'm gonna look at him. You know. And but towards the end, they kind of played.
Yeah, and then Philip kind of put his arm around him, and Josh was like, "No, man," you know. So I thought that was funny, but just the fact that they started off talking about how they didn't want to do this, and they were joking then.
Yeah.
And then they just kind of made it awkward. So it's kind of like a funny point in the show.
Yeah. You know, good
Some
thing
comic
it doesn't,
relief.
Yeah, good thing it doesn't count. By now, exactly. It doesn't count towards anything. And what about I didn't even like the melody. I didn't even like them singing together. Yeah, I didn't like the harmony.
It seemed like it had to be in a lower key so that Philip could sing it. Uh-huh. And then I felt like that meant that Joshua had to sing real low, which didn't work in his favor completely. But he kind of went off at the end and made it cool. He sounded good or whatever. So,
well, see, so who is it easier? Who has an easier time adapting? Would it be
Joshua?
Okay,
100%.
Yeah, that's a little.
But I think it's just because he has more experience singing with people. It seems like,
okay,
he's more well trained.
Yeah, limited range. Phillips has his more limited range. But he's great at what he does.
Yeah,
and Joshua,
the singer songwriter versus the range thing.
Yeah,
but the cool thing I thought about, like the girls, was to see all three girls who all have huge ranges, and just you got to see their personalities, whatever before, but it kind of gave us an opportunity to compare, like, okay, who's the one, you know what I mean? So I felt like it was good. They kind of messed up the dance move at the very beginning, like, Skylar and Holly messed it up because Jessica was on her own with the spin, and the other two girls kind of it was crazy, but we always ask.
Little
it always
meow,
happens. Yeah,
meow, meow. A little of that going on. You think?
I think a tiny bit. They're trying to act like they're just having fun, whatever. So. They said they worked very hard on it. It was a lot. It was a billion times better than the duo. But
what if they would? They said that they've done a trio earlier this season.
Yeah,
I don't remember that with those three.
Yeah,
but Because I was thinking, well, what if they would have done this trio like 2-3 weeks ago with Holly? Because I saw a different Holly there. Holly, you know, like usually, you know, Jessica's kind of the diva, and Skylar's the Spitfire, and there's Holly, little old me. And this time, she came out and she was charging it. She was charging the stage.
Well, she had already did two songs that they said were awesome for both. That was 2 for 2. So she just, it didn't matter what she was doing. She's about to just be like, ooh, I mean, this
is
me.
That was good. That was awesome.
Yeah.
And, you know, so it's evening out. Thankfully, I mean, aside from all the conspiracy theorists say, oh, it's Philip Phillips to lose, but it's just neat to see that it's, oh God, I'm quoting like a Randy thing. It's anyone's game, you know?
It is.
But speaking of someone who's stayed in, he started as a church boy. We thought he was too gospel-y, and he's grown and he's shown so many things. Joshua Ledet.
Yes.
What'd you think?
I felt like... All right, he came out and did Ain't Too Proud of Beg, you know, a Motown hit from the Temptations, dressed very swaggly. And,
did you like it?
Just looked like Randy. But, I felt like it was cool. And, you know, with the big band, him dancing, whatever, and getting down with it or whatever. But I definitely like the second song better. It was the first one was like, okay, yeah, we know you can do that. That's awesome. That's cool. That was whatever. But let's go on the second song after this. Would you like the first song or?
Yeah, I usually like to go to the second after the first two.
Yeah. No, I'm just trying to go after, you know, what you usually do.
Yeah, I actually agree with you on the first song.
He's cool, you know.
He's been in a zone the last few weeks. I think he's been knocking just about everything out of the park. He gets too many standing O's, I will say that. Mm-hmm. And luckily he only got one tonight.
Yeah.
But
it seems like they're kind of pushing him now that Elise has gone. This time to push somebody else, and it seems like the show might be pushing Joshua, which is well deserved.
Yes, but I don't know if he'll sing. I'm wondering who he's gonna, you know, what kind of album he's gonna put out. I mean, he is evolving, but
well, they were talking about the R&B stuff, which is R&B's coming back anyways. It's about that time.
You think? Okay, you think he's the man to save R&B? I'm not saying that.
But I don't know. I felt like, you know, he definitely has a power voice, and
he's a fantastic singer. Mm-hmm. I was underwhelmed by the song. Once again, I thought it ain't too proud to beg.
It's hard to, you know,
and it's hard to speak badly about a timeless song like that. Mm-hmm. You know, but I think Joshua is bigger than the song itself.
Right. Yeah. And, I think so too.
And at the end of the song, I think I said it while we were in the studio, while we were watching. It makes me laugh whenever Joshua sings. Sometimes, if you've seen that old Eddie Murphy Coming to America movie, when he's dressed as the singer and he always goes, "Sexual chocolate!"
Right.
Yeah. I think that Josh is going to say at the end. I always think he's going to do that, but luckily he doesn't. But
I think this was
that does not sound like a good song choice. Just, I mean, I didn't see the performance, but that, I mean, it's a great song, like you say, but not for American Idol, not to show off you.
Well,
I don't know.
It was 60s night, so they had to do something in the 60s, but.
Well, he could have done something.
And this is a very rhythmic guy.
Oh yeah, he's.
Oh, then he should have definitely went to like the Harold Melvin and Blue Notes kind of deal. Like that's where I would have went. Commodore Zoom is an amazing song. Like,
was that 60s though? Commodores.
Well, Commodores. Yeah, you're right. I'm good. But just something. That song seems a little too fun, fast. I don't know.
Okay. Which it seemed like everybody in this that did a 60s song. Well, everybody did do a 60s song, but it was like a fast, you know, upbeat big band song. And
yeah,
I don't know. He worked it out. I felt like it was really good.
And here's going to be a funny thing. I guarantee tomorrow, Jimmy's going to say, Joshua, love Joshua. Great kid. He's got so much talent. He could win the whole thing, but wrong song choice.
And, was actually really good, man.
Thanks.
You've practiced that?
No, that's the first time I've ever done that.
That was really good.
That was weird. I was kind of like Holly. Him? I was kind of like Holly. I'm surprised that came out of my mouth. No, but here's the thing with Josh saying song choice. I mean, Jimmy blaming song choice. He picks the song.
Yeah. Or he has a big influence on it.
Yeah, tonight it was Steven Van Zandt from Bruce Springsteen and Sopranos.
Which was really cool to see them interact. It was him just giving Jimmy a hard time. So
they were going at it all night. It was probably for me, it was probably the most fun mentor like partnership seen all season.
Mm-hmm.
So definitely would love to see him back. Maybe have Steve Van Zandt, you know, he's a musician, he's been on the Sopranos. Here's some casting here. Maybe make him the mentor and move. I really want Jimmy as a judge.
You want him on there.
I want him on there.
Put him on the panel.
Yeah, but and before we forget, To Love Somebody, the Bee Gees song, was great. I loved it.
It was good, and then it was great, and then it was like, what? How can you even sing that? Like, they put the song in front of you, you can say, okay, this is going to have some crazy vocals, and it doesn't even take any time, and he just comes out there and just kills it. It's ridiculous. Just every single thing, doesn't hesitate, doesn't do anything, just all he does is sing ridiculous notes.
One dude is
gifted.
In that first verse, he had this growl that I had never heard him sing. I'd never seen him do.
Mm-hmm.
And it was a growl that you hear from like the old school, like the old like R&B artists from like the 60s. My dad would make me listen to these old school guys. And he had this like not a James Brown type of growl, but it was, and he just put it in there for a second. Yeah. And I was like, man.
It's like he's in his element. After last week, that great performance.
Oh, that Indie Irie song. Yeah. No, Indie Irie actually, she tweeted him. And she was tweeting while she was listening to the song. Say, mm-hmm. I think Ryan mentioned that. And he's like, she's like, oh my God. And she said, call me.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
She was last week. So he's got another little sweetheart fan. So Josh was awesome.
Just
and
ridiculous. So gifted. So yeah. Gifted. And but is it enough?
That is a good question that maybe we'll answer right after the break. We're going to take a quick commercial, come back with news, notes, possibly a special segment, and of course, predictions.
AfterBuzz TV.
Hi, I was once like you, a lazy, angry loner whose only joy was watching TV and surfing the net. And like you, after I'd see one of my favorite TV shows, I'd be so excited and have so many questions that I'd actually have to talk to my douchebag coworkers about it at the water cooler. Then I discovered AfterBuzzTV.com. AfterBuzz TV produces after-show webcasts and podcasts for TV series of all kinds, like post-game wrap-up shows for all your favorite TV shows. AfterBuzz TV hosts are industry insiders who break down episodes of shows, take calls from fans, and interview cast and crew from each series with over 60 different aftershows, from Boardwalk Empire to American Idol to Vampire Diaries to Real Housewives and more. Now, after a night of TV, I can ignore my stupid coworkers, who I hate, and go straight to my desk and watch or listen to all my favorite AfterBuzz TV aftershows and have all the TV fan interaction I need. Thank you, AfterBuzz TV.
AfterBuzz TV, what do you want to buzz about?
All right, guys, we are back. And, you know, in the past, we tend to do, like, the Zaba search, and we measure online presence, and that usually is a good dictator of who's going to stay or go. Well, we're changing it. We're going back to the old school. This has been around for years. It's the Dial Idol. And right now, I'm giving you an up-to-minute update of who can go home and who can stay.
Can't get this anywhere else.
Mark doesn't even know. You don't know what's going on right now. Mm-hmm. This is how America's voting. And the way they do it is by measuring the busy signals. So the more busy signals a certain contestant gets usually means they're getting the higher amount of votes. And checking in the top five here. And they don't have it in a particular order because it's so close. But it can tell you there's only one person they're sure of for this week. And it's their top spot. And I'll tell you right now. Let's go with possibly finishing between second and fifth, Philip Phillips. He's at the bottom right now. And this is up to the minute. It's up to the second. Jessica Sanchez. She can place anywhere between first and fifth. But she's right now fourth if we're looking at it by the math. And my phone just tripped out. Okay. I'm doing this on my phone. All right. Now, third, we have Joshua Ledet, who can finish anywhere between first and fifth. But right now they have him at about third. And then coming in at second, Holly. Holly's coming in at second. So, she's really bumped up. But who's first? And I'm eating a whole lot of crow. Skylar.
Wow.
They have Skylar finishing no lower than fourth. So she's guaranteed not to leave.
Wow.
So she's in. So that's like an exclusive. Basically, she will not leave tomorrow, according to Dial Idol, because we're the West Coast speed.
Right.
So, yeah, she's in.
Oh, right, yeah. So,
according to Dial Idol now, that doesn't take into account, like, your Twitter votes and people texting.
Mm-hmm.
But most of the votes do come, you know, I guess, through phone lines. Right. So there's your up-to-minute.
Very
interesting,
because they were correct about Colton Clayton. Colton?
Hey, it's been so long. It's a late night. No, Colton and also Jessica, they predicted it over Zaba Search. Right. So definitely check out Dial Idol, guys, if you want to find out up to date. And if you feel like your artist isn't doing as well as you think they should, start calling. Yeah. Definitely. So let's move on to, I guess you can even say that was news, but let's move on to some real news and notes.
AfterBuzz TV News.
Okay, pardon my language, but Dave Matthews wants to kick Philip Phillips's ass.
What?
Yeah.
Because he's trying to steal his, he's like the young version of me.
Pretty much. No, according to Meg Miller, Dave was approached at a movie premiere. And he asked him if he watched Idol, and he said, no, I kind of keep my head in the sand, you know, but I've heard about this guy. And
just like Phillips would do if he was Dave Matthews.
Yeah, there we go. Exactly. See, doppelganger. But, you know, but they asked him, and he said, you know what, I'm actually flattered, and more power to him. But then they were kind of joking around, and Dave said, well, I don't feel threatened, but you know what? He should actually kick my ass, so maybe I could retire, and then he can take over the band for me.
Interesting.
So it's cool. All tongue in cheek, you know. It's cute, but it's a lot of Philip Phillips news this week, guys. I didn't pick it that way; it just popped up.
Who has a girlfriend? So don't, ladies, don't get it. You know.
Well, that's true.
Don't get any ideas.
Yeah, because he's driving women crazy.
Yeah.
Judd Apatow, director of 40-Year-Old Virgin and the 5-Year Engagement, actually called into Ryan Seacrest this week. He called into Ryan's show, saying that his daughter, of course, is a big One Direction fan, and that his wife is a super fan of a certain Idol contestant. And Ryan's like, oh yeah, really, who? And he's like, Philip Phillips.
Of course.
And then Ryan's like, I empathize with you, brother. I have to hear this at the house as well. Because Julianne Hough is in love with him, and Judd's wife is Leslie Mann, who's, you know, she's in movies as well. So everyone, the list of Hollywood lovelies for this man to bed grows longer. But
so does that, do you think, okay, so here's like the whole Chris Allen thing from way back when Chris Allen won the whole competition, when he brought his wife and they showed her and she was part of, you know, him always, they show her in the audience, and Simon had said, like, that's stupid, that's going to hurt you, and he won. So, is this going to hurt him at all?
Showing
his girlfriend?
But here's the thing, but wasn't Chris Allen just a little more sweet about it? You know, because Philip Phillips,
he kind of was like, oh, yep.
Yeah, they panned to her and they left. And I'm like, ooh. And I looked at Mark and I was like, I wonder how long that's going to last. I hope the best for him, but just.
Right, yeah.
Chris Allen was.
But he's kind of weird. I mean, Philip Phillips is kind of weird about it too. He probably just going to put his head in the sand with it.
He's got a. Oh, nice. He does have cookie.
Bingo.
Cookie sits. Mark, you are firing tonight. I love it.
All cylinders.
But not now. All this. I imagine you guys are all super fans of also all the singing competition shows out there as well. We'll have a little bit of news outside of Idol. We also have X Factor news. If you guys follow the show, it seems like they might have found a new host, and that host is Gwen Stefani. Yeah, they're buzzing. They're really close to closing out a deal for.
I know they were still talking to Britney, and they even brought up like Miley Cyrus.
No, but those are judges.
Oh,
they want Gwen to be the host.
Interesting.
Yeah, and I'm like, ooh, I don't know how that's gonna work out there.
I mean, I love Gwen Stefani. She's, you know.
She said she could never really be a judge, but I think she'd be a great judge.
I think she would fit it perfectly.
But maybe they'll contemporize it with her being the host. It's going to be hip.
Instead of that dude's not doing it anymore?
Yes, Steve Jones. Yes, they let him go.
They let him go.
Shortly after the season. I think the show had been, they had wrapped up maybe 30 seconds after the season finale, and he was already fired. Yeah,
the way it was going, it was as if they wrapped him during the season. I mean, it was a rough ending.
It was pretty bad. Yeah, Ronnie and I did the show, and we just would always like, I would defend him, but he was gone.
Yeah.
He's with Entertainment Tonight now. Anyway, but before we get off track too much, they're offering her $7 million to host The X Factor. Nice payday for the Gwen Stefani, but finishing up with
No doubt it is.
Yes.
No doubt.
God, you are. Wow, we better finish this up before we get the hook.
5 minutes.
And the last one, now, another new singing show called Duets. I don't know if they may already be in trouble, but they already had a casting change. I don't know if you've heard of this show, actually. Mm-hmm. Elizabeth, she's actually at the taping of it tonight.
Right, yes.
So, you know, it's a show, the premise is you get to sing with your favorite artists, like Kelly Clarkson, Lionel Richie, the girl,
Sugarland,
girl from Sugarland, and Robin Thicke. Who's snoring? Really? Okay, I'll wrap it up. Okay, Lionel.
No, I mean, it was an exciting duet story. It was exciting. It was really exciting.
No, thank you for that.
Okay. It was so exciting.
Okay, no.
I'm excited.
Okay, well, you better get excited because they're going to contemporize it because Lionel Richie is gone. They got rid of Lionel Richie.
They're bringing in J-Lo?
Nope. Sorry, Ronnie. They're not bringing in J-Lo, but they're bringing on someone pretty bad himself. They're bringing in John Legend. Oh yeah, so it's gonna, that show's gonna have a lot of swag. It's hosted by Caduceus.
He's such an ordinary guy.
Like, he is.
He's
just an ordinary person. You took the words out of my mouth.
What is this? This is like bad comedy night over at AFTERBUZZ. Usually I'm the one with the lame one-liners, but you guys are awesome.
I didn't say my comedy was bad.
No, he was actually being honest.
Wow. Okay. Wow. I'll just get it everywhere. All right, but that does it for our news and notes, guys. But definitely send us your pieces, whatever you think, you know, that should be on the show, and we'll bring it up maybe next week. And now it's time for predictions.
Okay.
Ronnie's like, you did it too quickly. Okay, now coming up to the most important part of our show, the scary part, the part that makes you quake in your pants and you don't know what to do. It's time for predictions.
There you go.
And now, that's perfect. You're after Buzz TV. About
perfect.
Predictions.
All right, what are we predicting?
All right.
Who's out peace? No. Out of threes?
We always
Who's going to win?
We always start with the positive, right?
Right.
Who's your favorite tonight?
Man, I don't know. Who's your favorite?
Oh, really? But I'm going with, and it's an homage to her, and I'm going to butcher it, The Power of Love. Holly.
Yeah, really? Really? All right.
Holly was my favorite tonight.
Okay, she was my second favorite. I'm going with Skylar. I'm going with Skylar, then Holly, and then Joshua.
As your favorite? Okay, so who's going home?
Who's going home?
Who's going home? Who's your bottom?
The bottom three is doesn't deserve to be there. Joshua, I hope he doesn't go home. Philip and Jessica.
Ooh, okay. My bottom three are Joshua, Philip, and Skylar.
Oh.
And who's going home? Guys, if Mark and I aren't here next week, it's because we got in a big fight.
Yeah.
Skylar's going home. No. I'm predicting an upset. I'm sorry.
You just told me that Skylar was the
bottom three.
Yeah, but she said
that America wants her, yes.
Yeah, but you don't?
I don't.
I think Josh was going home just because even though he doesn't deserve to.
All right, well, all right, this comes that time. If you guys are watching us on AfterBuzzTV.com live, just make sure to stick around because revenge is coming up. It's going to get saucy and juicy, I hear. Doesn't it every week? But Mark, where can they find you?
Oh, that's a good question. Find me on Twitter, Mark E. Allen, A-L-A-N. How about you, my man?
You can find me at The Everyday Man. Hey, Ron, where can they find you? Besides the booth.
At Ronnie Jr. Media.
Uh-huh. It's exciting. It's an exciting one.
Uh-huh.
Or find us all on AfterBuzzTV.
Mm-hmm. Word.
.com. See you next week.
Good night.
Goodbye.
From Bing.com, executive producers Maria Menounos, Kevin Undergaro, Phil Svitek, and the entire AfterBuzz TV staff, we would like to thank you for listening to the AfterBuzz TV Network. To watch or listen to other after shows and post comments or questions, be sure to visit AfterBuzzTV.com. I'm Sir Richard Wentworth, and this has been a presentation of AfterBuzz TV.
Buzz you later.
The views expressed herein are those of the hosts only and do not necessarily reflect the views of AfterBuzz TV or its owners or principals.